there are three elements within the radio program which has been made based on these three elements. So first one is human voice, second one is sound effects, third one is the background music. So generally a program, it can be a docudrama, it can be a drama, it can be a radio play or radio feature, etc. All of them will contain all these three aspects. If it is a news, we might not be having a background music throughout the news bulletin, but in the beginning of the news bulletin and at the end of the news bulletin, etc., you will again have the music which has been there with the program. So there are effects which are also added in between. For example, if it is a radio drama, etc., then if you want to convey a story for the audiences, etc., there are sound effects. You also need to create a situation so that the listeners will understand the content or they will follow the story which is being discussed or which is being aired through the radio station. The programs might be recorded at outside the radio station also sometimes, but there is an environment where is you have to get the right kind of quality of the audio so that it will be recorded in a place which is more noiseless. Okay, if it is a studio, generally the acoustic treatment is done within the studio so that you will not get the echo or the resound of what you speak in the station. If it is a radio program, generally, as I said, it is a medium of sound. If it is a television program, as it is a audiovisual medium, you can hear and you can also see the content which has been projected through the television stations, etc. But because it is only the sound medium, if you are not able to listen anything from the station, you will be confused with the content or you will not know what is being transmitted through the radio station. So here, because of that, generally the sound clarity must be there, and a program when it is being going to be conveyed for the listeners, etc., it has to create a kind of imagination within the listeners when they are listening to the radio station, which means a right kind of music has to be played, the right kind of dialects are to be delivered for the benefit of the listeners. Because the radio is a medium of sound, we use microphones. The microphones are nothing but devices that converts the sound waves into electric energy. Again, when you are listening radio waves, when it is being transmitted, the speakers again will make them as a sound waves. So they will convert, the speakers again will convert the radio waves as the sound waves, and because of that only we are able to hear the content. So there are different kinds of mics generally we use in the radio station. Along with that, we also use different kinds of mics or microphones in the television stations to pick up the sound from the location. So here, RJs are the radio performers or the radio artists, etc. They are, when they are delivering the dialogues, etc., they use these microphones. Now, depending on the directions from where the sound is being picked up by the microphones, there are three categories of microphones. The first one is unidirectional microphone, second one is bidirectional microphone, the third one is omnidirectional microphone. So if it is a unidirectional microphone, the unidirectional microphone will pick up the sound from only one direction. Okay, so if it is a bidirectional microphone, generally the bidirectional microphone will catch the sound from two directions. It is generally used when there is a discussion which is going on between the two persons within the radio station. Then we have a omnidirectional microphone. The omnidirectional microphone which will catch the sound from all directions, which means 360 degrees from all the directions, the microphone will catch the sound, or the microphone will pick up the sound. If it is a radio station, generally these kind of unidirectional microphones are used so that the RJ or the radio artist or a radio performer, etc., when they are delivering the dialogues, etc., it will pick up the sound from the front side. So this unidirectional microphone will catch the sound from the front side, not from the back or the sides. Because of that, we'll get a clear voice of the performer or the radio jockey. So that is why these unidirectional microphones phones are generally used in the radio stations. Then if it is a bidirectional microphone, it will pick up the sound from the two directions. When there is an interview is going on, generally these kind of microphones can be used. And sometimes if it is an interview within the radio station also, we can use omnidirectional microphones. But because silence is maintained within the radio station when the program is going on, the probe will pick up the sound from the persons who are speaking in the radio station. So in the same way, even though if it is a television program, if you take the studio based program productions, etc., there are many persons who are there in the studio. There may be there are production assistants, there are floor managers, there are also the camera persons, those who are recording from behind the camera. There is an anchor person, there is also a guest. But here, because the silence is maintained because of the kind of microphones we are using for the purpose of picking up the sound, the noise might not be picked up by the microphone. Depending on your requirement, you will be using all these microphones. Okay, whatever may be the kind of mic you are using, generally the work or the function of a microphone is to pick up the sound from the subject, whoever may be speaking, whether it is a radio or whether it is a television studio. If it is a television station, etc., generally if with the help of the vision mixer, you simultaneously record the visual and also the audio which is coming from the audio console at a VTR or maybe any other device where you can record the audio visual content for the transmission. But if it is a radio, generally only the audio is recorded and the audio is being going to be edited in the radio station on the editing suits to add the music or add sound effects when it is needed. As you already know, a script is something which is a backbone for any production. Okay, a script is, if it is a television, it will have the narration of the story. Everything is written on the paper. The dialogue part, the audio part, and whatever may be the background music which has to be added, everything is been written in the script. Okay, if it is a radio, the same way, if it is a radio program has to be edited. There is a human voice. If it is an introduction part of a program, generally the announcer will announce the station, the frequency of the radio station, the program, and also the time within the announcement. So if it is a program, generally a program will have its own theme, its own jingle. So in the beginning of this program, generally the jingles or the theme music is played in the beginning and also at the end of the program. So here, the editing, when it comes to the editing part, generally this human voice is accompanied along with all these elements, and that is being transmitted for the audience. Okay, so here the human voice, when it comes to the clarity, generally first thing is you have to use the right kind of microphone to pick up the sound from the subject. The second one is the importance of a radio program. The effectiveness of a radio program, it depends on the script. Because it is only a medium of sound, all those emotions are to be carried by the subject. Okay, so because of that, a script has to be written in a way that is readable or understandable for the person who is acting as the subject. The subject may be a radio jockey or radio announcer or maybe a radio artist. Okay, here the audio or the sound or the voice of the person should be very pleasant. It should not have any kind of noise. How clearly you can spell or you can pronounce the content is more important if it is a radio program. Okay, if it is a audio visual medium, like you are able to hear me and you can see me, it is more or less you can understand what I am speaking because of the facial expressions or because of the sound you are maybe receiving. But if it is a audio medium like radio, all those emotions are to be carried only through the voice of the person. So because of that, the voice clarity must be there. If you see that radio grammar, etc., all the content which are to be read by the performer or RJ are to be written in simple conversational language. Okay, we should not use complex words if it is a radio program. If it is a television, you can use the complex words, but if it is a radio program, generally you have to use simple words which are generally understandable also for the listener. In the same way, more or less it can be read easily by the radio performer or the RJ. Then as I said, because of all those emotions, the anger, the happiness, or the surprise, or the fear, everything, all these emotions have to be carried by the human voice. It is important that RJ has to convey the information in a way which will be understandable for the listener, and it should evoke the interest within the listener when they are listening to the radio station. The human voice is an important element in the radio station. The human voice is something which has to express all the emotions which are to be delivered for the listeners. Then we have sound effects. So these sound effects are nothing but the sounds which are not generally or directly made by the performer or the RJ with the voice. Okay, so here we use different kinds of sound effects to convey a meaning for the listener. The sound effects on the spot may be made, and some of the sounds we may not make within the radio station, and those kind of sounds are recorded at fields, and those are again mixed while the radio program is edited. Okay, here the sounds we can make within the radio station or by the performer while the radio program is being recorded, etc., they are called spot sounds. So human voice may make some kind of noises, some kind of sounds, like somebody is maybe sneering, etc. Maybe it can be recorded on the spot. If somebody is pouring water from a bottle into the glass, etc., that can be recorded actually within the station also. And somebody knocking the door, etc., also can be recorded. But when it comes to the atmospheric sounds or the sounds which can be made by the nature, the sounds which are can be made by the living things in the environment, etc., all of them, because you have a sense, you can deliver whatever you want for the listener, but the rest of the things, because they are not in our own control, suppose if it is a dog, barking sound of the dog, lion, the roaring sound, the birds when they are maybe moving in and around, etc., whatever the sounds they are making, those are, we cannot record on the spot. Okay, so all these sounds are recorded and they are saved. All these sounds are again added when the radio program is edited. And suppose it is raining outside, the dropping of the water sound, etc., the water flowing sound, etc., all of them you first record, and whenever you need, these sounds can be added while the radio program is edited. Suppose if it is a conversation happening between the two persons, we have to create a scene like they are traveling from one place to another place, etc. The human, there will be a conversation that when we will reach the destination, etc. Maybe one subject asks and the subject maybe within few minutes, etc. But the traveling sound you have to create when they are entering into the car, etc. The maybe opening of the car sound, etc. That has to be mixed. Again, when they are closing the door, when they're traveling, etc., you have to create that crowd or the traveling experience. So all these things are to be added. So the closing of the door or maybe opening of the car door, etc., can be a sound effect. For example, you want to convey that a story is happening in a temple or crowded market, etc. First, you have to record the scene or the program at the place where actually it is going on, or either you have to record that audio and you have to mix with the human voice when you are maybe editing the radio program. So here the sound effects also play an important role along with the human voice to convey a story for the listener. Then again, there is one more thing, the music. So here the human voice and sound effects may convey the story, but along with that, to create some kind of tension, to create some kind of happiness or pleasant environment, etc. Or in the beginning and end of the your story or your program, etc., you need a music. So here the music is something which is already recorded. But when it comes to the copyrighted information, if you are using for your radio station, etc., first you have to get permission from the so-called persons who are the owners of copyright. But when it comes to the drama or a radio feature or a radio serial, etc., if you are using as a program format, you need to have this music which will accompany the human voice and also the sound effects. For example, if you want to create some kind of tension among the listener, you use a music which creates some kind of emotion, some kind of tension when the story is being narrated for the listener. Depending on the theme, depending on the story, what you are using, or depending on your radio feature or your radio drama, etc., you will have this sounds or the music which is being created by the persons, because you are hiring them by paying some money. The artist will provide this music. They may play the music, and the music can be recorded within the radio station. So the radio will have its own, the music artists are the persons who provide this music. Okay, that can be added. So because you are hiring them, there is no need of violation of copyright. But if you are using for the commercial benefit of yourself, etc., when you are maybe without quoting, without sourcing, without taking permission, if you are using, then it will become the violation of copyright. After the expiry of the copyrights, you can freely use the music which is even composed by somebody else. Okay, if it is a radio play, radio drama, etc., from the beginning to the end, to create some kind of emotion, to create some kind of continuity in the program, etc., we use this background music. So here the story will have these, all these background music, sound effects, the human voice, all of them are arranged in different kinds of layers when the audio is edited. Then that has been exported, then that is going to be aired for the listeners. Okay, here, which means a radio program is something which is a combination of all these elements, the human voice, sound effects, and also the background music. And if it is, there is a no background music, etc., there will not be a continuity from one scene to the another scene. Like if it is a television where you use video transitions, the same way in radio also you can use different kinds of audio transitions like fade. So wantedly, sometimes silence is also maintained. Silence also will convey a lot of meaning for the listener. For example, if one character slaps the other character, what happens? The other character will remain silent. He may be thinking of why he has done that. Okay, to create some kind of emotion there, maybe you will have a few seconds silence. Wantedly, you can add this silence so that it will convey a meaning for the listener. The radio programs will have all these elements: the human voice, sound effects, background music. Along with that, sometimes silence is also an important element which creates a meaning for the listener.